ladies and gentlemen. My name is Timothy Harvey, and I'm here for SciFiForMe.com. This is my three-minute recap for Sleepy Hollow, the second half of the season finale. You'll notice that the first half of the season finale is a slightly not as sharp version, and we're filming this on a better camera for this here in our secret underground lair at Sci-Fi for Me headquarters. If you watched our previous episode, and hopefully you did, our previous recap, you'll see that we had a lot happen, basically building up. The primary thing was that the quest for the map to Purgatory and the saving of Katrina ultimately resulted in Ichabod destroying the map for fear of betraying Abby, for losing her friendship, for being in a position where he would have to choose to save the world, save his wife. Great bit. Very exciting, and of course, completely undone by the fact that Ichabod is revealed to have recreated the map using his photographic memory at the end of the episode. This pretty much picks up right from there. Ichabod manages to stumble across a historical reenactment, which will probably get him some new clothes. But more critically, Henry Parrish has a prophetic dream, where during the upcoming eclipse, the second horseman, the horseman of war, will be emerging. And the only way they think to really combat this is to use the map of Purgatory to rescue Katrina and use her in a weapon in the war. Oddly enough, we don't get a whole lot of Abby saying, "Hey, wait a minute, you told me you destroyed it. I saw you destroy it. What do you mean you've recreated it?" It's a little bit of that there. But again, the bond between these two is such that she lets it pretty much go. They travel to Purgatory with warning from Parrish that do not give in any temptation, do not accept any gifts, do not eat anything while you're in Purgatory. Classic myth stuff there. Even though Abby is confronted by Sheriff Corbin and a pre-dead Andy, and Ichabod is confronted by his father and a return to England and a future there, they do not give in to temptation. They find themselves again. And Purgatory is an interesting place. The people in Purgatory are visually very interesting. There's some very disturbing visuals involving the individuals. The background is a forest. It loses some impact, which is a shame. But the concept is pretty cool. They find Katrina. It's revealed that the only way to get Katrina out is either for God forgiving her, which would get you out of Purgatory, or someone else taking her place. Abby agrees to do this. Ichabod is not at all happy about this. You can definitely see the bond, the friendship there. And it's very interesting because, of course, Katrina seems very much outside this dynamic. But they do leave while Moloch closes in on Abby. She basically runs through Purgatory to escape him. She finds herself in a dollhouse sort of place where she finds something that was taken from her and her sister 10 years ago as they were first encountered Moloch in the woods. Meanwhile, back in the real world, Jenny is doing her own investigation through Corbin's files. She finds that there's a church. There's a mystery about the church. The name of the church is a mystery that Corbin was trying to solve. She goes to investigate. What she will find there and what Ichabod and Katrina discover when they return is the same thing that Abby's finding out in Purgatory, and that is that Henry Parrish is a lie. John Noble's character from the beginning has been basically the villain. He is, in fact, Jeremy. He's Ichabod and Katrina's son, the one who was buried, the one with the golem, the one who was twisted and warped and buried alive by the quote-unquote good witches. Moloch raised him from his hidden grave 10 years ago. Moloch turned him. Jeremy is the second horseman. He is war. And he's been shaping and twisting and directing Ichabod and Abby to this point to get Katrina released, to get things where he wants them, all in the service of Moloch. It's a shattering ending for our characters here, with Jenny in a headless horseman arranged car accident, with Abby trapped in Purgatory with no chance of escaping, with Ichabod and Katrina victims of Jeremy's sorcerous powers as he's bound them to these trees, and then he summons the headless horseman. who has a long and not so great history with Ichabod and Katrina, and Jeremy gives Katrina to the horseman. Ichabod's not very thrilled about this, but he doesn't have a whole lot of time to worry about that particular thing because Jeremy has taken him, bound him, and buried him alive in Jeremy's own grave. Basically, we end the season with, everybody pretty much without a whole lot of hope here. It's a great place to end it. It's fantastic. It's all the crazy that we've come to expect from Sleepy Hollow we've had in this two-hour season finale. And just everything about the characters, you know, all those bonds, everything that's there, very, very strong in this episode. Really, really enjoyed it. But I've enjoyed the show from the beginning. A lot to look forward to in the fall. You have you like the episode, didn't like the episode, we have a comment section. We'd love to hear what you folks have to say. I'm going to wrap this up because way over 3 minutes. Folks, you can find us on social media. You can find us on Facebook, Twitter, Pinterest, YouTube, Instagram. You can hear our podcasts on scififorme.com radio. You can download them from iTunes, Double Twist, our RSS feed on the website itself. You can find us pretty much everywhere at this point. So we hope you'll keep tuning in. We hope you've enjoyed this. Thanks a lot, folks. We'll see you in the fall with Sleepy Hollow.